one of the benefits of an ongoing relationship, sister-sister relationship with a church and you know, from the United States or wherever in the world with a church here in Haiti is that there is that opportunity for that ongoing transformation. The relationship that we have with God is one that continues to transform and take and change shape. And when we engage in relationship, whether it's with people in our home or people in our neighborhood, to be able to have that kind of relationship with a church from another culture across the world, it's one of those things that show up and let God show you how He can really transform you.
You're the God of this city. You're the King of these people. You're the Lord of this nation. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. You are. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. Greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city. Greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city.
You're the God of this. It was an amazing time. You come into a country like this with some fears of the culture and things that you don't know, and God took care of everything. The schedule was perfect, the people were incredible, the culture was incredible. We were completely watched over on this trip. I mean, it couldn't have been any better. God wants us to go out and tell all nations, and God wants us to touch people. We could definitely come down here and do a one-time project, a one-off project, and go back home. And we certainly, in that experience, would touch some people. But with a church-to-church relationship that I would hope would be a long-term relationship, we would have the opportunity to come down here and have an ongoing relationship with them, learn from our brothers and sisters, hopefully having them learn from us as well, and being able to draw more people from that town into their church and to God.
Well, the kids and my daughter were out playing soccer and having so much fun. Two little girls from who live very close by came to see what was going on and to just watch the action. And these two children were very, very dirty and in tattered clothes and not well. That was difficult to see because I couldn't do anything right then.
A relationship building trip benefits us in that we can hear the heart of the people. They can hear our heart. We can pray for them. We can help them in what ways we can in a that will affect them in a lasting way.
As we develop our relationship with our church, my hope and prayer is that the work in the local church will impact those children and the hundreds of children that are just like them.
It's a person-to-person relationship. And they can see what our needs are. They can pray for us. It's a joint effort. And it does as much for us as it does for them.
We, as a group, have already been blessed from that church relationship by the way the Haitian church received us with songs and praise and loved us and served us in a way that I feel empowered to go for a long time after that encouragement. They encouraged us when I thought we were there to encourage them.
One of the things that's most exciting about Reciprocal Ministries International is the fact that when people come down here to Haiti, they come down to serve, and that's awesome. They come down to extend the kingdom of God, and that's great. They come down to do relief work, that's wonderful. But what often happens is that they come home more changed than they ever expected. They come home literally different people. Their worldview is different. Their understanding of who God is different. Their understanding of what the body of Christ looks like, it's completely different. They come back transformed people. They come back more ready to be on mission for Christ. Still to be the head.